Hello. I want to say that I am a Mormon church trained pro-life activist, as well as a result of my Mormon background, a gay rights activist. And I'll tell you why I'm a gay rights activist. Because my father was one of many homosexuals at that time, gay, who were encouraged to hide these activities and to marry. It was thought that a normal sexual relationship with a woman would cure. Well, my father was also afflicted with alcoholism. And let me say that his mother was a very good woman. And his sisters. I never missed a church meeting. But his father was busy on the ranches and away a lot. And his mother simply could not control her rebel, wild sons. So all four of her sons started drinking. Now the Mormon word of wisdom is extremely strong against drinking. And I have to say that I have lived all over that state. I have lived in Garland, Utah for a couple of years. That's in the northern part where I went to high school, because there was no high school in southern Utah where I was born and raised. I lived in Salt Lake 7 years, going to school, going to university. I lived in my own hometown of Boulder, Utah, up and on many years. And I lived in Kanab, Utah, Cedar City, Utah, the town of the Shakespeare Festival, well known all over to theater buffs. I lived in St. George, Utah, which is famous for being the summer residence of Brigham Young. And it is a mecca for seniors too, because it's a warm climate to retire. I lived in Panguitch, which is the county seat of the Garfield County where I live. So, and I went to churches in all of these when I was young. All of these towns. Salt Lake, of course. I only lived a few blocks from Temple Square. So I felt that those imposing buildings, the Mormon Temple, Salt Lake Temple, was right outside my door that I could look and see. So the Mormon Church had a profound influence on me. And since, when I went away to school, my aunt, who was absolutely would not hear of me missing a meeting, including the ones during the week. My aunt on my father's side was the school teacher in southern Utah. She became, after she retired from teaching journalism and English in the high school in the northern part, Bear River. So I was surrounded, actually, and then in Utah, Salt Lake City, I had many, many relatives living there who were on my mother's side. And my grandparents on my mother's side were very active in the Mormon Church, as were all a number of that family. So I had an upbringing where I got the benefit of all of these people and all of the teachings. And I saw that as far as active church members. We're practicing the word of wisdom, which was totally against alcohol and tobacco. And an active Mormon was highly pressured not to do any of those things. So you more or less had to be a Jack Mormon to feel comfortable drinking, and as my father did, who did not set foot in the church if he could help it. My grandfather didn't drink and smoke, but he was a free thinker. He did not believe. He had been a cowboy, a professional cowboy. He drove a herd of horses twice to Chicago. That takes a lot of skill. And he did not marry till he was 30 years old. Well, what he had done for sex was going to be a mystery. But I believe that in his case, and in my father's case, there was a tradition of hiding, men hiding women, anybody who was practicing anything homosexual, hide it. What does this say? This says that in a religious state, a state that dominated to the point that Utah is by one church, which in many cases has benefited Utah greatly, it says lying is all right. Cover up is all right. Not going to work. It's not going to work because there are always predators. And the predator that changed my mind completely about keeping quiet about gay activities as all right was a molester. The very man that I heard revealing sexual activities, talking about them in front of me. Later on, this man molested me. 45 years old, molesting a 5-year-old. This is okay? Well, it seemed to be, because I couldn't find anybody to tell about this, because nobody wanted to know homosexuality was going on in Utah. That was the bottom line. We want that concealed. Why? To make Utah Mormon's church look good. That's not a good reason. It's not a good reason for anybody to conceal what is really happening and what is affecting people around. I was the victim of this kind of thinking. And I said, when I started growing up, honesty about your homosexual activities is right, is better than lying about it and covering up. And everybody who isn't gay should be able to recognize that. That it is better. If you cannot control, if that is what you feel the strongest, your gay orientation, then you'd better be encouraged by your society, the law, the church, to reveal it, to admit it. And this should be something that families, brothers and sisters, accept and get over their repugnance, their shrinking away from such ideas. Because it is a reality. Why shrink away from what takes place so much behind closed doors, shielded by lies? How does that make a child feel to hear and see a father lying about what he's doing? Because he can't stop doing it. Because his feelings are going so strong in that direction, he's bound to find partners which would usually be a hired man. Yes. And my mother just didn't quite comprehend this. It was like, she was a very well-read woman. She read everything. At that time, she was a very big reader, ordered books, belonged to book clubs. I turned to her for reading material all the time. But she hadn't read enough, heard enough, that she hardly comprehended, or didn't seem to. If she did comprehend it, she was not going to mention it. Why? Because my father would act totally insane if that subject came up. You did not talk about such a subject around the very person that it applied to. I did not discuss this subject with my father my whole life. And I did not discuss what happened as a child until I was in my 50s. Because it was taboo. So what are you saying? You're saying, if you're molested, it's taboo. A little child cannot talk about this. Too often, that's the message you're getting. You don't get, we'll help you. We'll listen to you. Why did I get in trouble in the university? Too many professors, just like my father. They weren't alcoholics, but they were hiding a sexual orientation. Lying about it. All over the state. If you ever encountered someone who was apt to be gay, and that did happen, my professor was Mormon, my head of my department. He was a famous Shakespearean director. Does it surprise you that he may have been had a gay homosexual side that was covered up by a wife and children? So what does that say? Oh, we need a wife and children to cover this up. Boy, that's going to be lovely to be the wife or be the daughter who finally comprehends this a lot sooner than anybody expected. So it's no wonder when I got to the university, I was stressed and strained. The more I realized, I couldn't even surface this kind of problem at the university because there were too many professors hiding the same thing. And I encountered a very brilliant English student who picked me for his cover wife. I said, oh no, I am not going to be your cover wife. He was older than I was, absolutely brilliant, read everything, but he needed a cover wife. It was required to look good. That was just about when I gave up on the university, where life had to be told, where I had to comply with custom, with the thinking of the time. I was not going to live the life that my mother lived with my father, because he started the infidelity. Right outside her door with a hired man to comply. Not pretty. Not pretty at all. And woman is expected to look the other way. Daughter expected to look the other way. Not being able to surface this is what caused me to leave the Mormon church. Especially twin to make it look good. They go after gays, gay rights, and they have not addressed in their own state this problem. The Catholic Church has almost gone down because of molestation by priests. They have the huge problem of demanding abstinence and not getting it from taking priests who cannot keep that commandment by their church and have to have sexual contact, even if it's with children. So what do we have? Then we have their superiors feeling so high pressured about this that they cover up. And who's the victim? Who's always the victim? The one who cannot speak and defend themselves. The children. Not for years. So I determined that one day I was going to write a book and I was going to tell the truth, the absolute truth, about what I experienced in regard to the homosexual relationships going on around me and being hidden and lied about. So I think there are a lot of questions that people have to ask themselves about what religious is. Is it to be honest? Is it to tell the truth? That's what I think of religion as being. Not lying and covering up. It takes courage to tell the truth. Every homosexual person knows how much courage it takes to come out. And yes, then we have to discuss molestation. We have to discuss the predator. We have to keep track of our predators. We have to know what they're doing. We have to face. We have to ask children. Assure them they can tell the truth. They can get help. I'm sorry if I get a little emotional at this subject. But as far as I'm concerned, it's a very important one. And it's a part of my activism. And always will be.